Go on. Head towards the light. Come.
Behind a raft of smock-added comments. You know, you cannot stay in the way of progress.
I'll leave it up to the gods and fate.
Do you think the gods play dice, Mr. Quirvis? Not at all. They run programs of self-replicating algorithms in their quantum supercomputers. High-frequency training at sub-light speed. Chaos theory to mold the future of their transactions through which they manifest the future, Mr. Quirvis. Reality is a collage of corporations inexorably linked and determined by immutable bylaws of time and space. The multiverse is a business, Mr. Quirvis. A business.
Scott, do you understand a word of what he's saying?
It's so simple, even a chimpanzee can get it.
I'm sorry. Maybe you could slow your speech or run out and find me a private.
You will learn to regret being so thick in this Griffiths. One way or another, the last gas saloon will belong to the Leviathan.
I won't stand up and show you the door, because I've been tempted to show you face to the wall again and again.
You know,
who knows, it might knock some decency into you.
You will live to regret your decision. You will be crushed by the full force of the Leviathan and the corporatization of death. Money, 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 money is your god. Money, 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 money is your god, Mr. Griffiths.
Forget what I said. Choose your window, you're leaving.
You haven't heard the last of the Leviathan.
What are we gonna do, Mickey? Going up against the Leviathan might be quite enough more than you can chew.
I don't know, I can chew quite a bit.
Balderdash, balderdash. You know, you can't have a little drinky poo.
Oh, Monster, what an awful cough.
And don't say that, I've been practicing it for weeks.
Do you mind? We are trying to figure out how to deal with the corporatization of death.
The corporatization of death? You know, since my parents died, I have so many things I wish to say to them, like, look at a shark!
Look, who are you?
My name is the Cunning Salingus, Gentleman Spy, and I've come here for a little drinky poo.
Well, you're in the right place.
I'm good, because I was attending Alcoholics Anonymous, but I've been finding it hard to stay anonymous.
You've tried giving up drinking?
Yes. I gave up drinking in 1969. It's the worst 20 minutes of my life.
This is the Electric Cool Elemental SpeakEasy!
The Electric Cool Elemental SpeakEasy?
Yes.
Oh, I think I'll give it a miss. Yes, a little Miss United Kingdom, a little Miss United States.
If bullshit was music, you'd be a brass band.
But...
It's from the Leviathan. Says here, the Leviathan has bought up the dead one up on the bar. I've got 2 weeks to pay up, or they're gonna repossess the speakeasy.
What are we gonna do, boss?
Right now, I'm sick of thinking. Annie, ready.
So that's it? You're going to drink and do nothing?
That's right, we're men. We drink and we do nothing.
Until it's too late!
No, no, Mickey. We can save the day if we all work together.
I'm not sure I fully should, too.
We need to liven things up a bit. Put on a show.
Uh-huh.
We need someone with a bit of pizzazz. A new musical director.
Who have you got in mind, Angel Kicks?
Someone talented. Someone unique. Someone sexy.
Well, Beltane. Okay, luscious lips. You convinced me.
Yeah, right.
This is a great idea, boss. Put out the call. Invite the finest performers in the multiverse to audition to be the artistic director of the Speakeasy.
Why, thank you. One of my better ideas, if I do say so myself.
Lyrical dexterity of its words, man.
understand them, Mickey?
No. I guess like most people in Glastonbury, when they can't talk sense, they talk in metaphors.
Freeze! Nobody move!
Hey, call me Mickey.
Hey, keep away from my man.
Now, let us speak, Angel Cakes.
It's all right. I am a woman. I understand. I wouldn't trust my husband with another woman. And he's been dead for 25 years.
Let me show you what real talent looks like.
I am not to stand for this. There is too much jazz in this show. That is why the SpeakEasy is in so much trouble.
We need
some real music.
You little tramp!
Ooh. Well, Scarlett, I always knew you had it in you.
You know, I feel much better.
Presence of an imbecile.
Or a
genius! Check it out! You've never seen anything like this!
Come on, darling. You can do better than that. that. Tell the truth.
Well, I must resist. I'll only
give
you
my... intelligence, is that a contradiction in terms?
Well, you don't...
Don't you tell me you're not like the others. You're a gentleman spy.
I am a gentleman spy. Do you have a significant other?
No. I've been married 3 times. My first husband was a counselor. And all he ever wanted to do was talk. My second husband was a writer. And all he ever wanted to do was write. And my third husband was a nice cream toaster. And all he ever wanted to do was... God, I miss him.
Come on, darling. Don't you want to sleep with me?
No, thank you. I know you secret service types. You'll be in and out faster than Edward Snowden. I'll be none the wiser.
You're an agent for Burhard, aren't you? Give it up. I'm after the golden time.
What gives you that idea?
Word of mouth.
So you think I am in a competition with you for the golden tongue?
If there's any competition for the golden tongue, my good lady, I'd win by several laps. Now come on, give it up. I know you have the golden tongue. You must have it, darling, please.
Oh, so the truth has come out. You are a fictional character from someone else's dream.
I don't know what you're talking about.
You've drifted into the plot of another play. There is no golden tongue here.
But there must be a golden tongue. There's this big green fellow at the front who told me about it.
Man in green, you say. Was he, how you say? Tall? Strong? With thighs like a liquid of fire?
Yes, that's the fellow. And he's built like a stallion. You're onto a real winner, eh?
So it's true. Inspector Gwyn is trying to pass himself off as the Summer King. Fair with us, there is a plot.
Inspector Gwyn must be working for Glowheart. We should team up against him.
Whatever it takes to get you through the night, darling. Maybe there is a one in there.
Who's gonna help us?
Well, you know how the multiverse is a symphony of vibrating atoms.
Yeah.
And you know that each frequency band is made up of 7 levels, like notes on a keyboard.
Okay, now you're losing me, Shibitush.
Stay with me, knucklehead.
Okay, clear as night of this.
Listen up. It's easy. All we need to do is raise the vibration of the SpeakEasy 3 octaves. And the corporation of death won't be able to manifest here.
Okay, sister, but how do we do that?
I'm working on it. But to defeat Leviathan, we need to form a plan.
We should sit around in a circle and work on our option. Oh, about Glastonbury. How many people in Glastonbury does it need to change a light bulb?
Huh?
100. One to change the light bulb, 99 to run a workshop on it.
The truth is, we still have the badass Mr. Tumnus. He could still come through with a showstopper. A showstopper that could rescue the bar.
I wouldn't rely on Mr. Thomas. That dude is bogus.
Yeah, we overheard him plotting with businessmen to get back.
Listen, folks. There's no reason for you to sit through all this boring plot stuff. Why don't you head on to the lab and see if you can pick up a pen?
I object to
You think that's bad, folks? Just think, what if nothing exists and we're all in someone else's dream? What if only that not exists?
What about nothing exists and everything's an illusion? In that case, I definitely overpaid for this suit.
The creeping corporatocracy of death must be stopped. The multiverse needs more love, less paperwork.
Not to mention violent death and the nationality.
Listen, me and the guys don't plan about Thomas selling his soul to the devil. We have a little stash away and we'd like to pay off your debts in return.
In return for what?
In return for a 50% stake in the bar.
I'll think about it. Okay, I've thought about it. I agree.
Hey!
That just leaves one problem. Inspector Gwyn. How do we deal with him?
Don't worry about Inspector Green. I have come on a secret mission to find the missing Summer King. Gwyn has captured him and is using him as a servant, slave, on setting himself up as the Summer King so he can sleep with the Maid Queen of cause mischief on Earth.
What? Well, I don't know if we can trust her, Mickey.
Angel Kiss, let her speak.
To experience true love, we must be willing to open ourselves up and sacrifice part of our heart and part of our soul. We must be willing to give of ourselves freely, and we must be willing to suffer. It is only when we expose our inner selves to the white hot flame of rejection that love can burn so brightly as to join two souls, melding the two into one, creating a bond that joins forever. It is from this bond that we draw strength eternal and power everlasting.
Oh, let me have! Think I'm gonna puke!
I will take care of Green, and then you will be free to dance. Dance your heart song in love freely.
How are you going to do that?
I'm going to kick him in the buttocks, hard, lovingly.
All this flowery stuff won't make kissing time. How are we supposed to combat the Leviathan? Don't tell me hold hands and arm.
Hey, that's a great idea. We'll form two interlocking circles, and
the old Vatican Pisces rules.
Well, you know, the old ones are the best.
Why don't we all just hold hands and sing rainbow songs? Oh, no, come on, I don't think it's got that bad.
Yeah, come on, Scarlet. The Leviathan men, they have machine guns. At least we can respond with harsh language.
Oh, Mickey, why are you worrying about bullets? You're already dead, remember?
Part of me not accepting it. And it's the part that doesn't want to have this suit dry clean.
This is the underworld, a place where energies grow. If we hold a high enough frequency, the Leviathan's men won't be able to hold their form here. In short, they won't be able to be here.
I'm arranged to meet the May Queen here. Ooh. Ah! There you are! It's not your usual haunt, but what are you doing down here this time of year?
I couldn't wait, my sweet. I thought I'd come down and see what you got up to.
Well, you know I don't like to mix my work and pleasure.
The sap's rising early this year. Can you feel it? I thought maybe a little satchel might be fun.
That might be fun. Yeah.
But first, Miki tells me you've been a bit mean. He says that you gave him a ticket.
Well, he was harboring no gnomes.
Whoa, I don't think I could get all prenuptial if you were so mean. But if I thought it was kind of forgiving, then, well...
$250,000 for my leg over. Let me have a think.
That's not all. And as for Ian Funk, fucking Duncan, fucking Smith, what were you thinking?
Now wait a minute, he wasn't one of mine. He comes from a much darker place. He's one of the dark gnomic knights on the dark, dark, dark side.
And here's Morgan.
He was one of mine. Sorry about that.
And the cruelest thing, the nastiest thing, is that you took this archetype. The man who represents the true male energy, the return of life, reproduction, fertility, love and beauty. The figure revered throughout time by unknown groups of people. You take this man and you call him Nigel.
It tickled me at the time.
Go! Oh, come on, then. If you're ever in real trouble, all you have to do is whistle. You do know how to whistle, don't you?
Remind me.
You just squeeze your cheeks together and walk!
Okay. This is a rough place. The sea gets warped inside Hades, populated by every cutthroat and ne'er-do-well from Alpha Centauri to the constellation of Draco. Why is it even worse than Shep to Manor? And I know that is impossible. What I don't understand, Nikki, is why a man like you would choose to stay here in the first place, tell me.
I got a wonder that myself.
Now, come on, Mr. Greenbeard. Why?
I once knew a fella.
And?
He'd come to Dundon. One day, he took all his clothes off, smeared himself in hot chili sauce, and dived into a bed of sticky nettles. I asked him that same question. Why? He said, seemed like a good idea at the time.
So you think you can mock me, Mr. Quickfist? Well, you're wrong. Is this due to some kind of emotional stance?
You think I'm mad, but there's a connection between your emotional stance and excessive masturbation.
You think you can defy the Leviathan, Mr. Quickfist? Prepare to meet your doom!
Out of town, and the music is first rate.
Frankly, Mickey, I don't give a damn.
Again.
Just make it all.